Guys, what's up? Welcome to World News 20 News Channel. So let's talk about Indian Cobra Genome Decoded, how this knowledge can help fight snake bite. This week, an international team of researchers reported that they have sequenced the genome of the Indian Cobra in the process identifying the genes that define its venom. This, they hope, can provide a blueprint for developing more effective antivenom. Are existing antivenoms not effective enough? Their efficacy varies. Besides producing side effects in India, the challenge has been producing antivenom for the species known as collectively as the Big Four, the Indian Cobra, Common Crate, Russell's Viper, and Saw-Scale Viper. A common antivenom is marketed for the treatment of the bites from the Big Four, but its effectiveness came under the question in a study published last month, not connected to the one that sequenced the Cobra genome. While the common antivenom worked as marketed against the Saw-Scale Viper and the Common Cobra, it fell short against some neglected species and also against one of the Big Four, the Common Crate. Accidental contact with snakes led to over 1 lakh deaths across the world every year. India alone accounts for about 50,000 deaths annually, and these are primarily attributed to the Big Four. Why has production of the effective antivenom been challenging? Venom is a complex mixture of an estimated 140 odd protein or peptides. Only some of these constituents are toxins that cause the psychological symptoms seen after snake bite, but antivenom available to the today does not target these toxins specifically. Antivenom is currently produced by a century-old process. A small amount of venom is injected into a horse or sheep, which produces antibodies. These are collected and developed into antivenom. This is expensive, cumbersome, and comes with complications. Some of the antibodies raised from the horse may be completely irrelevant. The horse also has a lot of antibodies floating in its blood that have nothing to do with the venom toxin. One more problem with the horse antibodies: our immune system recognizes it as foreign, and when antivenom is given, our body mounts an antibody response. This leads to what is called as serum sickness. Led author Sizagori told some news agencies. Also, next time if one is unlucky and has a snake bite incident, even if it's a different snake and they are given a horse driven antivenom, the body is going to have a severe allergic reaction. How does decoding the genome help? In the Indian Cobra genome, the authors identify 19 key toxin genes, the only ones that should matter in snake bite treatment. They stress the need to leverage this knowledge for creation of the antivenom using synthetic human antibodies. Targeting these 19 specific toxins using synthetic human antibodies should lead to a safe, effective antivenom for treating the Indian cobra bites, Sizagori said, and the logical next step would be obtaining the genomes and the venom glands from the other three of the Big Four, as well as deadly African species, leading to a possible common antivenom against bites from all four. Is genomics the only way forward? Sunagar, who led the study, is part of an international consortium funded by the UK Department for International Development looking for to develop new generation antivenom. We are trying to produce highly specific antibodies to counter the toxic effect of the snake venoms. The aim is to produce antibodies that are broadly effective not only against the snake venom in India but also in the sub-Saharan Africa. Ask about the Cobra genome sequence. Sunagar said it is already high quality sequence information of the genes that code for random proteins. It's very important for the production of the recombinant antivenoms. However, there's a week long way to go from the genomes to effective anti-snake venoms. So if you like the channel, so kindly subscribe to it.